also a head of one of the major development corporations in Vancouver. He said that if it wasn't for the Olympics, they would have found something else to create all of this development. So that was one of the things. There's this attempt by the government and corporations to build Vancouver as a global city, to have a lot of attention there, to kind of make it a much more world-class city, drive up tourism, those types of things. So the legacy basically was of development, and then also creating a heightened security context, having more CCTV cameras than had ever been in Vancouver before. And it was also the biggest peacetime military operation in Canadian history. But so that's kind of a lot of, that's kind of what happened in terms of developers and security around mobilizing. There's much more to say, but I want to focus a bit more on the opportunities for publicity that was being for different social movements and the coalitions that were built. So when Olympics comes to a city, it tends to affect things like environment, labor, anti-poverty groups tend to get involved, civil rights groups. And then there's also the issue of Indigenous land rights in Vancouver, because it's one of the only places in Canada where no there hasn't been treaty signed, so it's unceded Aboriginal land. So there's a lot of issues around that. There is different, these are just examples of some of the posters and some of the publicity that was happening at the time. So starting in 2002, to the Olympics itself, there's a whole bunch of different actions that happened. Initially, after the bid was announced that they were going to be hosting in 2003, probably the more major acts of resistance happened, more direct action things. These centered mainly around environmental issues. There is the Eco Ridge bluffs just outside of Vancouver that were, they're part of an old growth forest, a very sensitive ecosystem, and to build the highway that was through a mountainous range that was going to connect Vancouver to Whistler, where the two different events were happening. They had to kind of bulldoze through this whole area. So they did a blockade there, and it lasted about 2 weeks, kind of preventing the construction. And 24 people were arrested, and one of the elders from the Coast Salish Nation that was around there was put in jail for 2 weeks, and then when she was released, she ended up dying. So it was a very intense action on the police's part. The other major one was a series of housing squats that happened under the logo Homes Not Games. A bunch of different people squatted in vacant buildings in the downtown east side of Vancouver, calling attention to that these were empty buildings that should be developed for social housing rather than just being sat empty until the point where it could be gentrified with the Olympics. So then more closer up to the time when the Olympics was coming, in the months leading up, there was a series of public forums that were organized through the Impact on Communities Coalition. They're a group that were trying to make sure that the promises that were made about it being inclusive, about it being sustainable, were going to be met, that they were going to do those. So they were hosted a bunch of forums that looked at issues of civil rights, that looked at homelessness, gentrification. There was also a convergence that brought together a bunch of activists a couple days before the Olympics happened, and it had some training on what to do if you were arrested, different health and safety type things, but then also kind of coordinating actions that were going to be happening, making sure that the lines of communication were open. There was also demonstrations and protests while it happened. One of the most, I think, unique or creative ones was the Anti-Poverty Olympics that had happened every, it was, 2010 was its third year of happening. So they had this really festive event where people got together and kind of had, there's like welfare hurdles and things like that with mascots that were cockroaches and bed bugs and things like that, kind of drawing attention to the issue of homelessness and poverty. And the year of the Olympics, they also had a torch relay race that went throughout the province of BC, calling attention to poverty throughout the province, not just in Vancouver itself. So it brought all of this attention to the issues of poverty that were being exacerbated by the Olympics itself. There was also a series of demonstrations that were organized through a whole bunch of different groups coming together. There was forums between the activists themselves kind of talk about that. So I think that in general, there are these two different legacies that are left by Dylan's coming to Vancouver. One of them is the legacy of gentrification, of increased militarization of the city, those types of things that we're well aware of happening. But I think there's also a positive legacy of building coalitions within the city. So there's been the continued actions of things like tent cities. So a year after the Olympics, people squatted around the Olympic Village saying that there's a promise of having 66% social housing. Then there's the recession and all of these things. So it got dropped down to 10%, but most of them were just, again, being empty and being sold at $1 million each. So people were protesting that. There is a continuation of this question of rights to the city. There was a conference held that was bringing up the idea or bringing people together to talk about the increased presence of police in poorer areas, gentrification, the building of market condos, things like that. And then there's also been this digital archive that's been created that documents all of these different histories that were happening, media coverage, the posters. So it has some popular media representations, but also then the voice of people organizing against itself. So I think these are some ways that the history of the resistance is able to be preserved, and people can then know that it wasn't just accepted, it wasn't just celebrated as this great event, it was also resisted, and these are the reasons why. So I think in looking to Vancouver for things to build on,